Hello everyone, in this section we will learn about oxoacids of chlorine. In the past section, as we discussed about the oxides of chlorine, in this section we will learn mainly about the oxoacids of chlorine and not in general but a comparative study of the oxoacids, different oxoacids of all the halogens. So basically we have four types of oxoacids, that is hypohalous acids, halous acids, halic acids and perhalic acids. Specifically here I have mentioned the formula for hypochlorous acid, that is HClO, HClO2, that is chlorous acid, HClO3 chloric acid and HClO4 perchloric acid. Now, due to very high electronegativity, fluorine forms only one type of oxoacid, that is hypofluorous acid, but chlorine, bromine and iodine forms all four series of acids, that is hypohalous, halous, halic and perhalic acids. Moving on to the study of various types of acid series that we have and discussing about their properties like their acidic strength and oxidizing power mainly. The first category that we have is hypohalous acid. Since I just mentioned that fluorine forms this series of acid, so there are basically four type of acids in this category, that is HOF, that is hypofluorous acid, hypochlorous acid, hypobromous acid and hypoiodous acid. The structure is mentioned here that the halogen atom is attached to one OH group in a tetragonal fashion, though it has a linear shape, but it is arranged in a tetrahedral fashion where the halogen atom is surrounded by three lone pair of electron and one bone pair of electron. As far as the acidic strength is concerned, HOF is most acidic and the acidic strength decreases as we move from HOF to HOCl to HOBr to HOI. Now the reason why there is a decrease in the acidic strength as we move down the group from fluorine to iodine. What actually happens is that as the electronegativity of halogen increases, the release of proton becomes more faster, or in simple words we can say that the compound, the oxoacid, becomes more acidic. As it can be easily seen if we consider the structure of HOF. So what actually happens is that fluorine is very electronegative. So because of its electronegativity, high electronegativity, the bond pair of electrons of OF bond are stretched more towards fluorine. As a result of which, what happens is that oxygen is quite electron deficient in itself as compared to fluorine. Now because of this electron deficiency of oxygen, what happens is that the release of means proton becomes easier, as the shared pair of electrons of the OX bond lies more towards oxygen. Okay? Therefore, the acidic strength decreases. As we can easily see that as the electronegativity, as we move down the group, what happens that the electronegativity starts decreasing considerably. Fluorine has the highest electronegativity, but when we move to chlorine, to bromine, to iodine, the electronegativity decreases. Therefore, the shared pair of electrons of the OX bond, they lie more toward the oxygen rather than towards the halogen atom. As a result of which, like in HOCl or HOBr or HOI, the electron pair lies more towards oxygen, because of which oxygen has means sufficient electron balance with itself. Now it doesn't have a need to extract that electron richness from proton, and as a result the proton can be easily left over and therefore it is more acidic. The next category is halous acid. It is formed by only chlorine, bromine and iodine. Fluorine, because of its very high electronegativity, does not form this fluorous acid. As far as the structure is shown, again it has a normal tetrahedral fashion in which the chlorine atom is bonded to one doubly bonded oxygen atom and there is one OH group attached to the chlorine. The order of acidity is that HClO2 is more acidic, than HBrO2, which is more acidic than HiO2. And the reason is again simple, that as the electronegativity decreases, the shared pair of electron lies more towards the oxygen atom, and as a result, proton is set free for liberation. The next series is perhelix series, that is HXO4, with 4 oxygen atom. So in this particular case, what happens is that as the electronegativity decreases, the tendency of XO3 group to withdraw the electrons of OH group towards itself decreases. Therefore, as a result, acidity also decreases in the order. HClO4 is more acidic than HBrO4 and then HiO4. Next is talking about the oxidizing power of these species. Like in particular HXO4 type species, the central atom, that is the halogen atom, is present in its highest oxidation state. Therefore, it has a tendency to go to -1 oxidation state, and hence it acts as a very good oxidizing agent. Now, the perhalates, they are stronger oxidizing agents, and it can be easily proved through their electrode potential value. Like if we see that BrO4, the standard electrode potential value is 1.74, for IO4 minus it is 1.64, and for ClO4 minus it is 1.19. Therefore, with a decrease in the electrode potential value, their tendency to oxidize other species also decreases. Now, acidic strength of oxoacids of same halogen atom, like we are comparing hypochlorous, chlorous, chloric and perchloric, that how can we differentiate that which one of the 4 S series of the same halogen is more acidic? We are talking about this particular series. So there's one very simple way, that higher the oxidation state, more is the acidic nature. So if we go by that particular rule, it can be easily seen that in HClO4, chlorine is +7. In HClO3, it is +5, then +3, and then +1. As the oxidation state decreases, the acidity increases. And this can also be explained in terms of conjugate acid-base pair concept. Like HClN, it dissociates in water with the liberation of H plus ClO minus, ClN minus is the conjugate base. Therefore, as the number of oxygen atoms in any conjugate base increases, so what happens is that the d pi b pi bonding would increase, because chlorine has vacant d orbital and oxygen atom has lone pair of electrons. So more the number of oxygen atom, more would be the back bonding or d pi b pi bonding, and as a result of which the negative charge is more dispersed, or we can say in other words that the conjugate base is more stable. Therefore, the order of stability is ClO4 minus would be maximum stable, followed by ClO3 minus, then ClO2 minus, and ClO minus. And stronger the conjugate base, stable the conjugate means stable the conjugate base, it would be weaker, and its conjugate acid would be stronger definitely. Therefore, HClO4 is more stronger than HClO3, then HClO2, and then HClO. The next important topic is hydrogen halides, and these are represented by a general formula HX, which is HF, hydrofluoric acid, HCl, hydrochloric acid, HBr, hydrobromic acid, and HI, that is hyperiodic acid. Now, preparation, these can be simply prepared by treating hydrogen with halogen atom. Now, the order of reactivity is fluorine is maximum reactive, whereas iodine is least reactive. Now, the reactivity of fluorine is as violent, because it reacts so vigorously with hydrogen that it almost catches fire. And with iodine, we again face one more problem, that it gives a reversible reaction with the means the formation of HI on reaction with the H2 plus I2 is always a reversible reaction. Therefore, we need to add some oxidizing agent to this particular reaction so that the reaction does not proceed in the backward direction. Some other alternate methods are also available for the preparation of these hydrogen halides. Like for HF preparation, calcium fluoride is mainly treated with sulfuric acid, in which we get a mixture of HCSO4 plus HF. Next is when NaCl is treated with H2SO4, we get HCl plus Na2SO4. Now we come to the important part of this topic, that is the properties of these hydrogen halides. First of all, the physical state is concerned. HF is liquid, whereas all other means hydrogen halides are gases in nature. HF is liquid, and for it is because of the reason, because in HF there is intense hydrogen bonding, and we know that in most of the cases, like we have seen in case of ammonia, it is liquid in nature. Ammonia is a liquid, then water is liquid, HF is again a liquid, and because of the same reason, that is intermolecular hydrogen bonding. HCl, HBr and HI, since they lack any such supramolecular or non-covalent interactions like hydrogen bonding, so these are basically gaseous in nature. Next is the order of melting point and boiling point. Again, going by the same rule, that the compounds that have hydrogen bonding have extensively high melting points and boiling points, and it is for the same reason that HF has the highest boiling point. And then the order is same, that higher the molecular mass, more would be the extent of van der Waals interactions, and therefore more would be the boiling point. Therefore the order is HF greater than HI, which is greater than HBr, and it is greater than HCl. In a similar fashion, when we talk about the melting point of such substances, what happens is HF, because of the hydrogen bonding, it has slightly lower melting point than HI because of its molecular weight, and the order is same, that is HI greater than HF, which is greater than HBr and HCl. Next is the acidic strength. As we move down the group, the bone dissociation energy basically decreases because of smaller cation and larger anion. So there are very weaker interaction between the two species, and therefore the release of protons become much easier, and because of this HI is most acidic, whereas HF is least acidic. As far as the thermal stability is concerned, again it is directly proportional to the bone dissociation energy. And just 1 second before, I told you that as we move down the group, due to the huge differences in the size of the proton, that is H, and the halide ion, it is getting larger and larger as we proceed down the group. Therefore, what happens is that the bone dissociation energy decreases, and as a result of which the thermal stability also decreases. Therefore, the order of thermal stability is HF being most stable and HI being less stable. Next is the reducing nature. It depends on the ease of decomposition. Means higher the bond dissociation energy, higher would be the stability of the HX, and therefore the reducing character would be less. Reducing character is what? Mainly the means addition of any electropositive species. When HX would lose proton, that definitely the proton is gonna add to some other species, thereby reducing itself, reducing that particular species. Therefore, the order of reducing nature is HI is the strongest reducing agent, whereas HF is the weakest reducing agent. Next is the important compound of chlorine. It is bleaching powder. It has a molecular formula of CaClO twice, that is calcium hypochlorite. It basically has two components, that is calcium 2 plus attached to 2 ClO minus units. It is a white solid, and its strong smell means it strongly smells of chlorine. Like we have often seen in swimming pools or in normal hour water, that there is a strong smell of chlorine, and we say that it is bleached water. So this is the same purpose for which bleaching purpose is used. Preparation, it is prepared by treating slaked lime by passing chlorine solute gas through slaked lime. We get CaClO 2 plus CaCl 2. Next is, it is not simply a mixture of calcium hypochlorite, but it is a mixture of CaCl2, calcium hydroxide, and the mixture of dibasic calcium hypochlorite and dibasic calcium chloride. The properties on reaction with CO2, it gives Cl2O gas, and its aqueous solution is basic.